Mr. Sellers, what in your view is a meaningful definition of soft power?
Thanks for that question, Sebastian. A meaningful definition for me would be around a nation's ability to create a proposition of value to its interlocutors, to other countries, which makes it more attractive to that other country or its people. So it's around transmitting values and creating a mutual understanding and empathy, and therefore an element of trust between different parties, which creates attraction.
Why is soft power particularly important in today's interconnected multipolar world?
Well, it's always been important. We had a good discussion earlier about this. I think what's changed is that people, especially leaders or people who want to influence, have become more aware of soft power and the different mechanisms available to deploy soft power. And this is in the context of a world with scarce resources, a world where we've got a huge population, and especially in large countries like India and China, these populations aspiring to a middle class standard of living, and therefore intense competition on the part of countries, international actors, to be competitive in economic terms so that it can provide those standards of living for its people.
What returns does research suggest governments should expect from investment in soft power?
Research suggests it's hard cash returns. So I showed a slide to suggest that if a country projects itself positively around the world by, say, opening cultural institutions in more countries, a 1% increase in the number of cultural institutions you've got around the world will result in a measurable percentage increase of foreign students enrolling in your country, and a measurable increase in foreign direct investment in your country. And that's just one example among many.